White hot. That is how Alexandria Real Estate Equities likes to talk about the current state of demand for life sciences space. And so to talk to us more about that is the company's executive vice president and regional market director for the greater Boston area, Mr. Tom Andrews. Thanks for being here at the BioBus Center.
Thank you very much, Mike. Yeah, the Cambridge market in particular, where we have a lot of property, is extremely hot. There's very, very little space available, historic low vacancy rates, less than 1%, in fact, on a pretty large life science lab R&D market. So it's really tough for tenants out there to find space. But with that said, there are lots of exciting tenants doing business in the market and discovering new medicines for patients.
Let's go broader, though. What about outside this area, the other biotech clusters like the Bay Area, San Diego,
sure.
Seattle, Research Triangle Park, New York, Maryland?
Yeah, we have a lot of property in those markets, and San Francisco in particular is also a very, very tight market. San Diego and Seattle as well. Our New York property on the east side of Manhattan has been fully leased now. No space available there.
Wow.
And the Maryland market and the RTP market are tight as well. So we're seeing it all over the place.
Tom, what's driving that? What's underpinning this historic level of demand?
We really think there are about five factors that are really driving it. First, you know, the NIH budget is up again. So the federal government is spending 8% increase this year over last year in NIH spending. So that's basic research that goes on at academic institutions and hospitals. Also, medical research philanthropy, you know, private foundations like the Gates Foundation, mm-hmm. The Broad Institute here in Cambridge, those folks are getting a bigger and bigger slice of the pie, over $30 billion in research spending in 2016 from private foundations on medical research. We also have great venture capital activity over the past couple of years, a record year in 2017, on our way to a new record for life science venture capital coming this year. On top of that, we have continuing increasing spending from pharmaceutical companies on their own R&D budgets. So those are four factors right there. And on top of that, we have a very accommodative, I would say, FDA that is really trying to get new medicines out to patients. And in doing so, they're approving more therapies than ever. This is causing new investment to be made in new therapies. They're looking at all different types of modalities. So a very accommodative and supportive FDA has helped. And then on top of that, we're still seeing
There's a sixth one.
I just thought of an open IPO window where companies are able to get public and raise new capital for clinical trials and to get new medicines into the market.
So firing on all cylinders right now. So despite all that, the record level of demand, the lack of space, Alexandria, however, is making room for nascent startup level companies in the form of what you call launch labs. And you mm-hmm. recently announced that you're starting an incubator, if you will, like that, right here in the Boston Cambridge area.
Yeah, and it's really modeled on one we started in New York last year. So it has space and services for new companies just coming out of academic labs, perhaps entrepreneurs who want to take their idea into the marketplace, and space services. We support them as well with our own network, with curated mentoring and support. And in addition to that, there'll be funding available from our dedicated seed stage capital fund, part of our Alexandria Venture Investments platform.
Great.
So we'll be opening in Cambridge later this year. We made the announcement a few weeks ago. It's under construction, and we look forward to opening in the fall.
How many companies will come in?
There's desks, I think, for well over 100 people. So I think we could have, depending on the size of the companies, there'll be dozens.
Nurturing the tenants of tomorrow at Alexandria Real Estate Equities to help create a vibrant, sustainable, durable life sciences ecosystem and community for the future. Tom Andrews, Executive Vice President of Alexandria, thanks for joining us here at the BioBus Center.
Thanks, Mike.